okay. So this would be my last video of the lesson. Hear me, students, and pay attention. Now, then, as commanded by the king, the dead tiger was taken in procession through the town and buried. Now, a great procession was there, and so many people came to the procession, and it was the order of the king that he should be buried in the town. A tomb was erected over it, and a tomb should also be built for the tiger. Now you can see the king was very happy, and he was taking a lot of pain for the tiger tombs also. Okay, generally very important persons are buried in the tomb, and the tomb is erected. But here the 100 tiger is very important for the king, as he was thinking that the cutter he had killed the tiger, but actually he who did not kill the tiger. The tiger was killed by the hunter. So it was the king's command that a tomb should be erected over it. A few days later, the Maharaja's son's 3rd birthday was celebrated. Now I think he had promised also, the king had promised to everybody in his kingdom that as soon as he will shoot the 100 tiger, he will do all the important things for his family, for the kingdom, for his state, and for the people of that country who had supported, who he used to think supported him. But actually he was not supported by the people. This we will discuss at the end of the lesson. A few days later, the Maharaja's son's 3rd birthday was celebrated. Now the king's son, he was having his 3rd birthday, and the king was free from the burden, from the fear that he would be killed by the 100 tiger. So he also decided to celebrate his son's birthday in a gala way. Until then, the Maharajas had given his entire mind over to tiger hunting. Now he wanted to forget. He already had enough. He had wasted enough time in tiger shooting. 100 tiger shooting was not an easy thing for him. It took a lot of time. And for that he had, did you remember, he married also to the princess where he could find the maximum number of time. Now he wanted to forget all those things. So until then, the Maharaja had given his entire mind over to tiger hunting. He had no time to spare for the crown prince. But now the king turned his attention to the child. Now the king really wanted to have some attention for his family. He started to decide the birthday, to celebrate the birthday of the prince. He wished to give him some special gift on his birthday. And he decided that he would give something very special to the prince as his birthday present. He went for the shopping center in Pratibandhapuram. So he went to the shopping complex where so many shops in Pratibandhapuram was having, and searched every shop. He went to mostly all the shop and searched something very special gift for his son, but could not find anything suitable. But he was not able to decide. He was not able to find something very suitable for a gift to his son. Finally, he spotted a wooden tiger in a toy shop and decided it was a perfect gift. A very, very important line. Finally, what happened? He went to a toy shop and where he found that, where's my ebook? Yes. And he found, what did he find? He spotted a wooden tiger. See here, I'm underlining it with red because this is the most important line of the lesson. He spotted a wooden tiger in a toy shop and decided it was a perfect gift. He thought that it is the most suitable gift for his son. The wooden tiger cost only 2 annas and a quarter. Now that was a very, not very costly, not very valuable. It was only 2 annas and quarter. That time annas used to be there in our country when our country was under the British rule. But the shopkeeper knew that if he had gifted such a low price to the Maharaja, he would be punished under the rules of the emergency. So the shopkeeper thought, if he will tell such a low price to the king, he might feel insulted or he might feel bad, and he would be punished under the rules of the emergency. So again he told a lie. And what he told? "Your Majesty, this is an extremely rare example of craftsmanship." He told me, "This is a very good example of craftsmanship. A bargain at 300 rupees. And finally, how much money he had taken from the king? 300 rupees. So that tiger, the toy, the wooden tiger, it was costing only 2 annas and a quarter. Instead, the shopkeeper had taken 300 rupees. "Very good. Let this be your offering to the crown prince on his birthday," said the king, and took it away with him. The king was very happy. He told, "Okay, this is very good. And this will be a nice offering from your side to the crown prince on his birthday." And he had taken, by saying, he had taken that wooden tiger. On that day, father and son played with that tiny little wooden tiger. Now that whole day, the tiger king with his three-year-old prince, he played with the wooden tiger. It had been carved by an unskilled carpenter. Now that shopkeeper, he had cheated the king. First of all, he had sold it with 300 rupees. That was a large amount of money for that small wooden tiger. And secondly, it was not carved well. It had been carved by an unskilled carpenter. Its surface was rough. The surface of that wooden tiger was rough. Tiny slivers of wood stood up like quills all over it. You have to learn this line, because as this line is very important, so you have to learn this line. Now, few important word meaning. The word meaning of sliver. Is, yeah, I underlined it. So what is the meaning of sliver? Please write it. Small thin pieces of something that is broken off from a large piece. Small or thin pieces of something that is broken off from a large piece of something. So some of the wood, some of the slivers of wood stood up like quills. You can see in the porcupine. So it was slivers of wood stood up like quills all over it. One of those slivers pierced the Maharaja's right hand. Now, what happened? One of those slivers, it pierced. Pierced meant, write it, make a small hole, or went through the skin. So meaning of pierced is went through or make a small hole. So that was it. Pierced the Maharaja's right hand. He pulled it out with his left. Now you have to remember that it was the right hand of the king where the slivers had pierced. The slivers pierced in the Maharaja's right hand. He pulled it out with his left hand and continued to play with the prince. Now, such a brave king, it was nothing to him. He took an important thing. He took it as a very ordinary phase of his life. In fact, he did not took care, and he was still playing with the prince. The next day, infection flared in the Maharaja's right hand. Now, this again is a very important, you have to learn this thing in 4 days. That means within 4 days, you have to learn it. How many days? Within 4 days. The infection flared in the Maharaja's. Flared means it is spread. It is spread in the right hand of the king. It developed into a separating sore which spread all over the arm. So it developed into a separating sore which spread all over the arm. What is the meaning of sore? It's like an ulcer, it's like a boil, and which had separated in his arm. That means separated means a pus was formed in the arm and the infection had spread all over his arm. Pus, when we get hurt, when the wound is separated, that means a pus was formed inside the king's arms and that infection, it had spread all over his arm. Three famous were brought in from Madras. Now, very famous surgeon. Surgeon means the person, the doctors who operate. So they were brought after holding a consultation. After holding a consultation, consultation means they decided to talk. They started, the three of them decided, the three of them discussed, and they decided to operate. And finally, they told the only solution will be the operation of the king's arm. The operation took place. And then the operation took place. The three surgeons who performed it came out of the theater and announced, "The operation was successful, the Maharaja is dead." Now see the satire here. What is a satire? What it is told? The operation was successful and the Maharaja is dead. In this manner, the hundred tiger took its final revenge upon the Tiger King. And with this, we have finished our lesson. So, first of all, if you are having any problem, you have to go through the lesson. Then I give you the WhatsApp number also. I posted my email also. And there you can ask the question. Okay. You can start your dog session from today also. If you are having a problem, you can ask me. Now, two important things which I told you, that satire and irony, you have to find it out. What is the satire? Where is the satire in the whole study? And which part is related with the irony? The story is a satire on the conceit of those in power. So who were in the power at that time, as I told you, it was the Tiger King and it was a British officer. Now, the comment, what was the comment or the here, what is the dramatic irony here, that the most powerful king who had killed 99 tiger, he died due to a small wooden toy, a small wooden tiger. So here it is an irony, such a brave person. He died not with the 100 tiger, because see, it was not he who had killed the tiger. It was a hunter who had killed the tiger. And the king was under this impression that he had killed the tiger. Okay. So such a brave king, such a person who was full of valor, he died due to a small wooden toy. And the satire is on those people also who were proving very faithful to him, but actually they were not faithful to the king, like the Diwan. Throughout the story, you can see that he was telling lie to the king. Even the shopkeeper, he he was a person that who really played a trick on King. The tiger, that small toy tiger, the wooden tiger was unfinished, but he is still praised that this is the most wonderful piece of art. So it was he who had played a dirty game on King, and the King believed it. Then the hunters also, they told lie to him. So the King, who was thinking that everybody is loyal to him due to his power, in fact, nobody was loyal to him. The three important, apart from the King, the three important people, the Diwan, the hunter, and of course the shopkeeper of the toy from where the King had bought that wooden toy. So this is the end of the story, and I know my voice might not be clear in some of the portion, as sometimes the connection was failing, sometimes lot of disturbance was there, but I will try to improve my video in the next lesson. So today go through the lesson. Any doubt you are having, please write to me, please send me an email. And if we will have online classes also, we will discuss. Today I already had one online classes with you people. Okay, so today only we will do till here.